I was thinking of going to Ustorset tomorrow. Would you like to join me? I can't. I'm in court on Monday and have to prepare. If I'd had the time to travel up there myself, I wouldn't have needed to engage you, would I?
This cabin, is it hard to find?
No. Are you going by train?
Yes.
You'll see it from the station. A log cabin with a blue door, roof ridge and shutters. Just follow the road east of the hotel.
At first, I felt like Spencer Tracy in Bad Day at Black Rock. Then I started walking. Ustaoset was dead for most of the year, but at Easter it was quite crowded. In a 5 kilometer radius from the station, there was perhaps the greatest concentration of cabins in Norway. In the section nearest the station, there was less space between them than between downpours in Bergen. The road up had been cleared, and sand had been strewn, so that owners could drive all the way to their cabins in their urban tractors, if they so desired. And they did. But not many had taken the opportunity on this doldrum weekend between Easter and the Skarvet cross-country ski race. Greyish-white smoke rose from one of the neighbouring cabins. That was the only sign of life I could discern. The log cabin I was making for lay deep in snow, with all the cogged corner joints filled in with swirling powder. The path to the front door had been dug clear, and there were half-covered boot prints on the way down. I gently tried the door handle, but it didn't open. So I took out the key Berit Breheim had given me, unlocked the door, and stepped inside. I groped around on the wall for a light switch. I found one, and the ceiling lamp came on. I was in a small porch with several pairs of skis around me.